no vlogs, and now loads all close together. Mad. So yeah, we are now doing our second go at Arena Eventing tomorrow at Coombelands. Very excited. So me and Kezzy Halona are going together. Kezzy's going to be doing the 70 and I'm going to do the 75, which is quite good because I was like, oh, they've got two classes really close in height, so we could both give it a go, which is nice. So yeah, took her out on a hack yesterday. She hadn't been out for a couple of days before that. She was fresh. Definitely had a little struggle getting her back on the second gallop, which was good. I mean, it was fun, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, so she's definitely up for it at the moment. So gonna do all her job. Oh God, I've been doing like a million and one things today. Bought a new box for all her stuff. Got a load more of her feed, done a feed run, need to sort that out. Obviously the normal jobs, ride her quick. I'm gonna just give her a blast, sort of gallop around the school. Not gallop, you know, but yeah, get some of the edge off. And then yeah, get some stuff ready. And then I'm helping my mum with a tack sale tonight. I might put some of that in this vlog, I don't know. So yeah, busy, busy, busy. And then I don't know the times for tomorrow yet. I was hoping to walk the course today, but I'm just not gonna have time, so we'll just do that tomorrow. Yeah. I feel like something else I was gonna say. No, I think that's it really. Yeah, so might not be the longest vlog, but I'm gonna do it. And I will see you tomorrow, I guess, or at the tack sale. Morning. Oh, early start again. And the weather is gross. I don't even see. It's raining in really. I think this is just going to be a short vlog today because I've got a lot to vlog about really, but main girl, stuff in her face. God, I am knackered. Yeah, I did tack sale with mum yesterday. I didn't film any because it was absolutely manic, so I managed to sell a few of her things, but I think she bought more than she sold. Shock. Okay. So yeah, I think I've already said what we're doing today. Coombelands Arena Eventing. I'm doing the 75, so a little bit bigger than last time. We've not been there before. Hello, gorgeous. We've not been before, neither of us actually, so be interesting to see how that goes. Whether it was she was feeling so confident last time because she'd been before, or she is just more confident now. I don't know. We shall see. So yeah, wish us luck. We'll probably see you back, I don't know, in the lorry or when we're there. Fingers crossed. Go to for cleaning boots, baby wipes. Really, what's happening? Jump 11, so I'm really freaking out now whether to do mine or not. She just said she brought her in on a bad stride and she just wasn't sure about it. It was quite a big one as well, off a corner, and she just ducked out. So yeah, really having a crisis. So I'm gonna look at, walk my round and then decide from there, I think. Round, I actually did do it, so I am very pleased with myself, but we got eliminated, so that's a shame. This one was very good. You came fifth in the 70. But yeah, you know what, I'm not too disappointed. I'm sort of half and half. I'm half disappointed just because it was at a jump that I was not expecting, fairly innocuous, big word, number 10, which was like a rustic show jump with some mushrooms, which she has had a look at because we've got some mushrooms at home. She's had a bit of a look at them before, but I just didn't think that compared to everything else that was going to be a problem. So we just ran out, and then to be honest, like, I probably could have ridden her much more forcefully and like gave her a whack on her shoulder and stuff for the others, but I think in the back of my head a little bit of me was like, if she's refused on this one that I wasn't worried about, the next jump was one of the ones I was worried about. I just thought, you know, maybe it's not the one for us. But it was really up to height. Hopefully you can see that in the course, and technical and twist, yeah, technical to be fair. So, well, it's just been a little bit too much of a push for us. But her, how she was before, was brilliant. She was proper, you know, going for it but in control just about. So yeah, I'm pleased with her mostly. Yeah, I'm pleased with her. Just yeah, maybe try and come schooling here, and it's just all experience, isn't it? So anyway, I'm starving, so we're gonna get you two home. Well, we're gonna eat, then we'll be here. So bye. So we're all home. Kids is happy, munching away. So yeah, just round that vlog up a bit better than before, but you know, not our day. It's probably the first day I've come away with none of my little personal goals reached as such, but to be honest, some of them changed once I was there. Like, a goal was actually to do it, because after seeing Kezzy fall off in her class before, which to be honest I thought, oh, hopefully, you know, they'll go round, she'll have seen everything and she'll feel more confident for my round, actually ended up going the other way. Well, for my confidence anyway, I don't know about hers, but yes, it's just one of them Bing's horses, isn't it? You know, had I known the course was as it was, then maybe we wouldn't have, maybe we'd done the 60-70 or something like that if we were going to both do a round on her rather than the 775, because it really was up to height, like compared to Pycombe, Jesus, it was smaller arena to start with, so much tighter turns, much more technical lines, definitely full up, if not quite big. We saw the 80 after mine, and some of the jumps were the same, so I'm just like, there you go, really. We've only done one go arena eventing, and I thought, oh, we'll go straight into that, but whatever, it's fine. But these are positives, to be honest. I'm like, more for me, actually. I mean, I'm really pleased with her. She dealt with the warm-up really well. We only had one little moment, and it was manageable. And when we got in the ring, she was same again, like proper loving it. The show jumps, oh my God, no problem with at all. So really, I've just thought, you know what? I need to crack on with 80 and carry on cracking on with that, because really, she does not have a problem with that at all. And I can ride that well, and there's just no worries really for me either of us on that now, it feels like. So that's really nice. We've got confident with that. And yeah, obviously just the cross country side of things, which I already knew, is just going to take time. So just experience. She did, you know, we still got through a fair few cross country jumps. There's actually, like, in both mine and Kez's classes, there was ones that I thought, gosh, she's going to have a real look at that, and she didn't. So, you know, got to be pleased with that. And yeah, it was, like I said before, it was a silly jump that she had an issue with. But you know what, thinking about it, like, if I'm totally honest with myself, I didn't ride her determined enough to get her over it. If I'd really thought, you know what, you're being stupid, let's go, and really got after her, I think she would have gone over. But I think in the back of my head, the next two jumps were the ones I was the most worried about. One was a corner that had an arrowhead lined up after it, that you weren't supposed to jump, so you had to make sure you got that line really good. And then straight after that was the one that Kezzy had fallen off at. So yeah, on my heart of hearts, yeah, I probably didn't ride it as well as I should have, and you know, she took advantage of it. So, you know, first run out, fair enough, I wasn't expecting it, did not think she'd have a look at that jump. Second time and that, yeah, my fault, should have got after her, and it's what it is. But actually, on the other hand, I think, you know what, self-preservation, I could have saved myself from something really nasty, because I thought as well, you know, if we're having a problem with this one, I didn't really think it would be a problem, and it looked fairly show jump like then really don't know what was going to happen for the others, because there was, even the very last jump was a horrible looking, like, piled loggy thing. I mean, well, you've seen it in the video, I guess, it's bright, and like, they never like bright stuff so much. The last three, there was no let-ups, it got worse basically. So really, it's fine. No, my confidence has not been lost, which is a big thing. It's very fragile, and hopefully her confidence hasn't been lost, which she hasn't hurt herself, you know, we're all safe and sound. So take it on the gym, it's all part of the learning curve, and carry on. So yeah, I'm glad we did it. I'm proud, you know what, I'm gonna hold my hands up and say I am proud of myself for doing it, because I bought the course on my own. I thought, bleep, my life, this is a hard course, like, do you know what I mean? Technical, full up, yeah, big. So I come out and Kezzy was like, oh, so what do you think? And I was like, mate, it's not good at all. So, but I did it, and there definitely would have been a time where I wouldn't have, I would have chickened out. So yeah, yeah, swings and roundabouts, that's horses for you, isn't it? So yeah, we all got home safe, we had a good day, more experience, just think of it as schooling, and it's what it is. So also, I'm going to say this now, so there may be future me will think this again, but me in mornings of shows needs to think of future me after the show and think, what's the last thing I want to do when I get back from the show? Muck out and do all of that. And what do? I leave it to do now. So past me, remember that for next time. I won't. It means I've got to get up early. I won't. But yeah, okay. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this, please like it, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.